Take your frozen hash brown patties and fill the bottom of your pan. Perfect fit. Now we're gonna take some frozen turkey sausage. This is in crumbles. I'm opting for the turkey sausage just because it's a little bit healthier, but you could use pork sausage if you like. Now we're gonna add some cheese. I'm using Colby Jack. You can use whatever kind you like. All right, y'all, now we gotta have some bacon. I'm just using these bacon pieces. Now these are real bacon, already chopped up. What we are doing here is showing you the quick and easy version so you can throw together a meal in no time.
Looks like our cleanup crew is here. Could you do me a favor and get me some eggs from the fridge?
Eggs?
Yep, they're right on the top shelf.
Eggs I can get, here we go. Eggs, 12 large eggs, great.
Perfect. Now, I do have a question for y'all. Let me know in the comments, how much are eggs going for you these days? You're actually gonna use 8 eggs for this recipe, but y'all let me know, why are they so expensive? What's the cause of this? My husband, Kyle, behind the camera, said he was gonna get me a dozen roses for Valentine's Day, but I said, don't do that, just get me a dozen eggs instead. It's worth more. All right, there you go. 8 eggs is all you need. Now we're gonna add some milk. I'm using the 2% milk just because the little bit of fat does help, but you could use 1% or even fat-free if you wanted to. Heavy cream works so as well. Now we're gonna add 1/4 cup of sour cream. Dump that right in there. And of course we're gonna add some salt and pepper, but I've opted to use this pink Himalayan sea salt. Y'all tell me in the comments why, but you told me this was better for you. This was something you recommended. You said stop using the iodized, so I did, but now I wanna know why that's better than the other kind. We're also gonna add some seasoning. We're gonna do 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder. Y'all like garlic powder on your eggs? If not, you gotta give it a try. And 1/2 teaspoon of onion powder. Hit that with some fresh ground pepper. And then we're gonna mix it up. And we're gonna try out my new handy dandy mixing tool. This is supposed to be less effort, easier to use than a traditional whisk. Let me know what you think. All right, we got our 8 eggs mixed up with our sour cream, our seasoning, and then we're just gonna pour that over the top of our hash browns. This is gonna be delicious. All right, that's it. Take this, pop it in the oven at 350 degrees for about 30 minutes even. Could you open that for me?
Sure.
And then you've got a 1-pan breakfast that everybody will love. It looks so good. Doesn't it smell good?
It does smell
good. I wish
y'all
could smell this at home. All right. We've got our hash brown breakfast casserole with our eggs, our cheese, bacon, and sausage. And there's one other thing that we're going to top that with, and that's some fresh green onions.
Okay. Let's cut this open. I'm excited.
I know. We're going to do the taste test in just a second. Let me know in the comments what y'all would add. And I do have an important question, too. So are these the same things as scallions? Are green onions the same thing as scallions? Is that a dumb question?
I have no idea what a scallion is. So
okay, so it's not as dumb of a question as I was afraid of, if Kyle doesn't even know what they are. Okay, is that enough or did I overdo it?
I think that looks perfect.
Now, just to be clear, y'all, we are learning as we go. We are entertainers having fun in the kitchen. And I love hearing your feedback because I can learn from you too. All right, I'm ready to taste test this. But before I do, I need you to answer an important question.
Okay.
Please settle this debate. Kyle and I have been arguing about this forever. Which is better for eggs, salsa or ketchup? Which one of these will go better?
Salsa.
Kyle's voting for salsa. I think, especially because this has potatoes, that ketchup is better. So let me know, with this breakfast casserole, specifically the eggs, salsa or ketchup? The winner of this vote, based off of what you say, will be having the luxury of not having to do the dishes for the next week. So ketchup.
Salsa.
Right. Come taste this, let's see.
All right, here we go.
It looks really good.
Here we go.
So we got a little bit of sausage, and we used turkey sausage because that's healthier.
This is exciting.
And we have some bacon in there, and of course we have the potatoes and the eggs and the green onions.
Okay, here we go. I hold the plate, get a good
piece. 30 minutes at 350 degrees, super easy. What did I miss in the ingredients? Was there anything else that you would have added to this one? All right, here we go.
All right.
And because of those hash browns down there, it should just scoop out perfectly.
Look at that.
Oh yeah, look at that now. We need a fork.
All right, looks good so far.
All right.
See?
Wait. Don't get mad at me.
Not on my piece. You can put that on your gross part and all. She's wrecked the whole thing.
I'm gonna give him that bite.
No, I don't want that. You need to eat the ketchup. I don't like ketchup on the eggs. It's not right.
Okay. But it's potatoes too. Here we go.
Okay. Good?
There you go. All try right. Your bite without the ketchup.
All right, I'll try this corner piece right here with all this cheese and stuff. Look at that.
I think it's gonna be good.
It's gonna be good, I guess. I can't.
All right. It's delicious. I mean, it's all the perfect breakfast things that you would put together.
Mm-hmm.
Potatoes, bacon, eggs,
it's like just
sausage.
It's like a breakfast in one pan.
Yep, one pan, super easy. I still think that the ketchup is good though because we've got the potatoes. Settle the debate, y'all. I'm really curious to see what they say.
Mm-hmm.